بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters in Islam, the problem after Ramadan is not that we slow down in our worship. That's a given. You're not going to be worshipping Allah like you worshipped Him in the last 10 nights of Ramadan when seeking Laylatul Qadr. However, the problem is that you stop worship altogether. And you neglect and you abandon the many forms of worship altogether. That's where the problem is. So long as you remain consistent upon these forms of worship, even if it's tiny steps, then that is the achievement and that is where you want to be after Ramadan. And there is a great principle that al-ulama rahimahumullah mentioned, and it is inspired by the words of al-imam Ahmad rahimahullah. This principle states, اجعل لك في كل مضمار قدرة به تبدأ ومنه تنطلق وإليه تعود. How excellent of a principle this is. Listen to what it means. It says that make a standard for yourself for every matter of worship. Make a standard. If you find energy, you increase on this standard. If you don't find energy and power within you, then at least you do not go under this standard. Now let's see examples and what this actually means. For example, let's say we're speaking about the worship of Qiyamul Layl, Salat al-Layl, that you and I were used to for 30 days of Ramadan, waking up at night and praying Salat al-Taraweeh, Al-Qiyam, Al-Witr, and so on. So if we're speaking about this form of worship, to stop this altogether, that's not a good habit. That's not an achievement after Ramadan. So this principle would mean that find how many rak'at you can pray at night that you are comfortable with, that you can make a standard for yourself. So if you decide, I am going to pray 2 rak'at every night, and then I'll pray 1 rak'a witr. So that's 3 rak'at every single night. Then that becomes your standard. You do this. If on one particular night, you find there is strength and energy within you, in where you can pray longer than that, then you pray longer than that. And if on certain nights you don't find this energy and will and power within you to pray, then at least you don't go under your standard. So you'll pray those 3 rak'at at night. SubhanAllah, what a beautiful principle it is to adhere to after Ramadan. If we're speaking about Adhkar al-Sabah wal-Masa', the supplication of the morning and the afternoon that we're supposed to be reading, then choose for yourself, make a standard for yourself. You'll say that in the morning, I'm going to read at least Ayat al-Kursi, at least Ayat al-Kursi. And one hadith, one dua or 2 dua of Adhkar al-Sabah al-Masa'. If you find energy and power in where you can read them all in the morning, then alhamdulillah, do so. But if on certain days you don't find this energy and this time, then at least you don't go under your standard and you read Ayat al-Kursi and the couple of dua that you chose for yourself. And similarly for Adhkar al-Nawm, the dhikr before the sleep. When it comes to your relationship with the Qur'an also, choose for yourself a standard. What are you going to read every day? You say, I'm going to read and try to understand to the best of my ability 1 page. Because the challenge here is to read and understand. So you say, I'm going to read and understand 1/2 page of the Qur'an. That's my standard. If you find energy on a particular day and you can read more, Bismillah, read more. But if you don't find energy and you don't find power within you to read more than that, more, then at least don't go under your standard and read that 1/2 page or 1 page that you've set as a standard for yourself. When it comes to as-sadaqah as well, from as-sadaqah, you commit onto this deed as well. You give, you set for yourself, mathalan, you want to give a sadaqah every Friday. So you say, I'm going to give a sadaqah every Friday because, of course, Friday is the best day to give a sadaqah. That's your standard. If you find energy, then give on other days. And if you don't find energy within yourself, then at least you don't go underneath your standard. SubhanAllah, what a beautiful principle it is. When it comes to fasting, this noble, blessed deed that we got used to for 30 days, choose for yourself a few days in the month that you're going to fast. The best days are Monday and Thursday. Or 3 days of every month, which are 13, 14, 15. The one who fasts these 3 days of the month earns the reward as though he fasted the entire year. Allahu Akbar. Imagine you did Ramadan in 6 days of Shawwal, and then you did 3 days of every month. You earn the reward of 2 years of fasting in only 1 year you live. Subhanallah, what a bonus it is, and generosity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when it comes to the deed of fasting, set for yourself a standard. You say, I'm going to fast Mondays, at least Mondays, every Monday of every week. If that's not even the case, at least one Monday a month, doesn't matter how tiny and how small it is. Nothing is insignificant in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you say your standard is, I'm going to fast the first Monday of every month. Alhamdulillah. If you find energy within yourself, then do more than that. And if you don't find energy, then at least don't drop under this one day a month. And remember, my brothers and sisters in Islam, and this is the golden hadith I wanted to share with you. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلْ. That the most beloved, can you imagine this word, أَحَبُّ, the most beloved deeds to Allah are those that are done consistently, even if they were tiny, even if they were little. Allahu Akbar. So the benefit, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the benefit of being consistent in worship is that you're ready. You're ready to meet Allah Azza wa Jal any moment. Why? Because you're upon a path which Allah Azza wa Jal loves. You're upon a path that Allah Azza wa Jal loves. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to remain consistent, because that's the challenge, right? He, consistency. It's not about how much you do. It's about how consistent are you going to be with that which you do. That's where the great and the real challenge is after Ramadan. How consistent are you going to be? This is why we need to understand the road is very long. There are people running on this road. There are people walking on this road. And there are people crawling on this road. It doesn't matter. The thing that matters is to stay on the road. That's the thing that matters, is to stay on this road. The speed, if you're given speed, alhamdulillah. But if not, then at least stay on this road. This is what Allah Azza wa Jal is pleased with. Tiny, it's the tiny steps. It's the small steps to Allah Azza wa Jal, the consistent ones that Allah Azza wa Jal loves the most. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to keep us consistent, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us steadfast upon His deen until the day we meet Him. Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.